Howdy, folks. All right, so maybe you've already watched the video on how to turn a fraction into a percentage. And now what we're going to talk about is we're going to talk about how to turn a percentage into a decimal. Okay? Now, in the video, if you just watched the one on turning a fraction into a decimal, you know that to turn a fraction into a percentage, you divide, you do the division as the fraction, then it becomes a decimal. Then you multiply by 100 and it becomes a percentage. And you also have to put the percentage symbol on it. Okay, so to turn it from a decimal into a percentage, you multiply it by 100 and then put percentage symbol on, right? Well, if you're trying to go from a percentage to a decimal, well, then you're just going to do the opposite of this. You're going to go backwards. If you multiplied by 100 and then put a percentage symbol on, well, to go from a percentage to a decimal, take the percentage symbol off of it. So 37%, get rid of the percentage symbol, and then divide by 100, which is the opposite of multiplying by 100. And 37 divided by 100 equals, so get my calculator, and I'll do 37 divided by 100, and that just gives me 0.37. And so, 0.37. And so to go from a percent, to go backwards here, to go from a percentage to a decimal, then we would simply remove the percentage symbol and then divide by 100. Okay. Now, if you wanted to go, you probably don't have to do this, but if you want to go from a decimal to a fraction, well, that's really easy. So 0.37, what you do is you basically move the decimal point. Well, actually, I'm not even going to make it that complicated. We're going to go back to this step. Do you remember here where you had the percentage and you took the percentage symbol off, right? It was 37%. You took the percentage symbol off and then you divided by 100. Well, guess what? It's a fraction. So it's actually, there you go. That's, you just don't even do the part where you key it in the calculator. You just leave it as 37 over 100. That's how you turn a percentage into a fraction, is you just put it, you remove the percentage symbol and put the thing over 100 and it's done. All right. Well, I hope that helps a little bit.